I'm Rick Emerson, and today we talk to either the gay Dave Barry, the male Bridget Jones, or the comedy works in threes, but I only have two, so fill in the rest yourself. Marc Acito, today on Outlook Portland, right here on Portland CW. I'm Rick Emerson, and welcome to Outlook Portland on Portland CW. There are, without a doubt, any number of words that are used with astonishing regularity on this program. Bacon, vampire, nerd, geek, zombie, waffle iron. And most of these words are, in fact, used in conjunction with another word, renaissance. None of this should be confused with making me a renaissance man. It simply means that I'm dull and entirely predictable. To find a true example of a multifaceted artistic overdrive, one need only turn to Marc Acito, who is seated to my immediate right. Okay. Make sure I get this correct. Novelist, humorist, playwright, columnist, opera singer, and winner of multiple literary awards. Have I left anything out?
Merry prankster.
Raconteur?
Well, you'll be the decider for that. How's that? I feel like there's a lot of pressure now to be adorable and clever. I'm not quite sure how that's going to work out.
You can be adorable, clever. I would also settle for wry or perversely amusing.
Sure, I'll go with that.
Reserve judgment.
Not to mention, I have very nice calves. Am I right or am I right?
It's true. Okay. And snakeskin shoes. Are those real snakes?
Those are real snakeskin shoes. I think they may be illegal. They're only available outside of the country, so you can't get these in the United States.
Are these Chuck Taylors?
The Converse. All-Stars?
How is it that you obtained snakeskin Chuck Taylors?
I've got an in at Nike. This being, you know, the land of Nike.
You're born in New Jersey. How did you come to Portland? And I guess the ancillary question there would be, how would you be different as an artist or a performer had you been born somewhere other than New Jersey? How much of an imprint was that?
Well, to answer this first question first, I came here through my own westward migration, my own manifest destiny. I went to school in Colorado and then just continued to the coast. Like so many people who come to Portland today, I came here right after I graduated college because it was affordable and creative and weird and sort of the artistic place that people could go. It's a much more nurturing environment. You know, everyone's doing their DIY thing in their basement with their zine or their website or whatever, and so I think it generates a really nurturing environment to create as an artist. The downside of it is I think we are still lacking in ambition. It's not a really great place to be self-promoting. I often get accused of being self-promoting. By New Jersey standards, I'm positively, I'd say...
You're a wallflower.
Exactly. But by Oregon standards, I'm really pushy. And I think we could stand to be a little pushier in getting ahead here.
What accounts for that sort of reticence on the part of Portland? Is it the size? Is it something just in the culture, in the vibe?
Honestly, I think we're the place that people go... It's going to sound terrible. We're the place that people go when they don't think they can make it in other cities. It's by that I mean we're essentially a city of mice who have opted out of the rat race. And it's not to say that we are also timid and we've failed elsewhere. Part of it is also we value having a yard and a sustainable lifestyle. And we want a life as opposed to, like, most of my colleagues and friends who, you know, many of whom are still living in their 40s and living in 800, not even 800 square, you know, 400 square foot apartments, walk-ups, you know, that they share with, you know, a number of roaches and rats. And I think the people come to Portland and say, you know, I'm opting out of that. I don't want that.
I've heard it said that people don't come to Portland, they sort of end up in Portland. And then again, as you say, a week becomes a month, becomes 10 years, becomes I am a Portlander.
I am astonished by the number of people I have met who live here because their car broke down here. I hear that story a lot. More so than you. I mean, one or two, you're like, oh, that's cute. And
right.
Then it seems to be sort of something that just kind of happens.
The only time I ever met anybody who lived somewhere because their car broke down, I was in just another fly speck on the map called Ritzville, which really is just a truck stop town. I mean, the primary industry, there's a truck stop and there's a gas station and there's like a flapjack house. And I stopped in said flapjack house at one point and the waitress came over and she was kind of giving me the sugar, where are you from thing, and we talked. And, and I said, so what brought you to Ritzville? And she did. She said, I had a flat tire and here I am.
Right.
And she kind of poured the coffee and sort of slowly
walked away. Is this Eastern Oregon?
Where
is this?
It's between Kennewick and Spokane. It's really a thriving metropolis of a place. No, trust me, it's I'm not selling it sufficiently.
Okay, yeah, really, I feel like I need to just get in the car and get up there right now.
Yeah, if I were you, I'd yeah, get a move on that
from
because
here,
it gets real bustly around 5 o'clock. That's when the stoplight turns on, so don't delay. All right. When we come back, we will continue to plumb the innumerable ways in which Marc Acito is more interesting than I am. That's when Outlook Portland returns, right here on Portland CW.